Greetings, and welcome to this week's Primed Insight. My name is Gavin Gooden. I'm the Marketing Director here at BlastOne. So last week, we had a call from a customer ordering a third truckload of abrasive, going to a job site that he told us was going to take 1.5 trucks. We said, stop. We'll send you the truck, but we're coming to site. We got to site, and we found that his abrasive metering valves were wide open. This is a problem we find at 80% of job sites we visit, and we're on job sites every day of the week. What I want you to understand is the importance of abrasive metering and what it does. Abrasive metering is simply restricting how much abrasive will flow into the airstream of your blast hose while you're blasting. It's how you save money on blasting. It's by accurate abrasive metering. I'm going to give you a demonstration of abrasive metering in our homemade metering valve. Here it is. Here's a bottle with a hole in the end. This is going to be our metering to show you the difference of abrasive metering. So first up, we're going to run slag abrasive, it's 2040, through our homemade metering device. So I'm going to block off the end here. This is a pound of abrasive. And we're going to time it. Are you ready? So now I'm going to run some 80 mesh garnet through our abrasive metering device without any metering, just to show you how fast it goes. Here we go. So we have a blast spot full, and our metering device is ready. Here we go. Now I have my metering device metered down, so I'm gonna save some money. Let's go and see how, long this blast spot lasts. Now I have another grade of garnet, which is slightly coarser, so I'm going to run this through and see how that works. So here we have the same metering as we did for the 80 mesh garnet. So now we're analysing the results, and we've got the slag and the garnet both emptied our vessel in 3 seconds when we had no metering. That means we're using between 1600 and 1700 pounds an hour. This has been common, what we've seen for slag in the industry, but about 4 times more than you need for garnet. So the 80 mesh garnet, when we metered it through this hole, it was about the same size hole as we have about 4 turns on a Thompson valve. We were using about 420 pounds an hour. On the coarser grade, because it's coarser particles, it flowed slower. It took 13 seconds, not 12 seconds with the 80 mesh. And we're using about 385 pounds an hour. So there you go. Now you understand what metering does to your abrasive. It allows you to meter it back and save money. So I want to touch on the 3 important points on why people open their metering valve, or why people have this problem. The first one, and the most common, is the operator doesn't know. They don't know that every job, you check the metering valve. You turn it all the way down, and you open it back up to start with 4 turns as an average. The second point, and the other most common, is moisture. Moisture is the number one killer of productivity on a job. And if you get humidity inside a blast pot, it's going to clump your abrasive together, so you have to open it up to let the abrasive flow, or you have to choke the blast pot. Because moisture is the number one enemy on a job site, you should always carry an air prep to every job site. Even if you're in Arizona, you need an air prep, because any drop of moisture is going to damage your productivity and performance by at least 10%. The third point is that most blasters think, more abrasive, the faster I cut. This is true to a point, but you've got to do your cost analysis. If you're using more than 600 pounds an hour of garnet, that is, you're probably using too much. It's easy to test how much you're using, fill the pot up, and time how long it takes to empty it. you can pretty soon tell by how many pounds you put in and how many hours it takes. Thanks for watching this week's Prime Insight. We'll see you next week.